flips it in wide of Swayman. Carlo finds Frederick coming back to the puck. To Grizzlick. Marchand's cross pass. Oh, a great tip in by Frederick off Carlo's drive. And the Bruins lead 3-2.
Take it back to the defensive zone and the effort by Brandon Carlo. I mean, he gets a little bit of a pick behind his net, but he's got a strong... He has to be strong on this puck to get the breakout pass to be completed and allows the Bruins to do things up ice. Frederick, nice little backhand feed. Grizzlick with a nice little backhand feed. Get the puck to the net, and there's your redirect. Oh. Well executed, well done. Gonna look at the overhead and the change of the direction right there. Get inside position. Get to the front of the net where the goals are scored. Redirect by Frederick on the net drive coming out from those left wing boards. After being right in the middle of the rush when he made that nice backhand feed, he didn't just stay to the outside, he got back to the inside for the tip-in.
Frederick, with his eighth goal of the season, has tied his season career high. And just an assist away from a Gordie Howe hat trick. Foligno drags the puck over the line to Coyle. Foligno to Frederick. He scores! Trent Frederic beat the Kings up and beat them on the scoreboard.
Not sure what Alex Edler was doing in the neutral zone. He came flying forward. I thought he was going for a big hit, but he was trying to make a play on the puck, I believe. And it allowed this rush here by Foligno. He tries to find Coyle. Doesn't quite get it off the stick. Almost went in off his body. And then how about that play by Nick Foligno? You got too many Kings behind the goal line, trying to get to the puck and the man. That's going to leave Frederick wide open in front. Copley sees it at the last second, but he's too deep along the goal line, and there's no panic in Frederick. He didn't just try to fire a forehand. He went backhand to get leverage and throw it up top.